Good day to all of you students. Today we will learn about complement of a set. So what do we mean by complement? So let us understand, children. If there is a universal set containing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is a universal set taken by choice. Supposing there is a set A which contains numbers 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. There is a set B which contains 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. And there is a set C which contains numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I want to complement of set A, I will write as A dash. This will be the symbol for A complement. Or some books also write as AC, C for complement. So, which elements will come in A complement, children? We have to leave out all the elements of A from U and write all other elements. Means A dash will mean all those elements which are outside A, which are not in A. That will be A dash. So, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, leave out these 5, whatever I am left out with, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. This will be A dash. What will be B dash? Leave out elements of B, write all others, that will be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And what will be C dash? Leave out elements of C, write all the remaining elements from U, that will be 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Thus, children, you can make out in Venn diagram, if this is A, this is U, then this region outside A will be A dash. And we can easily make out that A intersection A dash will be null set. They don't have anything in common because A dash will include those elements which are not in A. So no element can be common, the intersection will be null set. And their union will be full U, total U. This plus this will become the complete region. So please note these 2 points in the properties of complement. So you can make out what will be U dash. U contains all the elements. So U dash means all those elements which are outside U. But there is nothing outside U because U contains all the elements. So that will be phi. Phi dash will mean all those elements which are outside null set. Null set contains no elements. Therefore outside it will be all the elements. So phi dash will be U. Like this you have to think. And then we have two famous De Morgan's laws. They go like A union B whole dash will be A dash intersection B dash. Union becomes intersection and dash comes on both the sets. Now let us verify this by Venn diagram, children. A union B dash, I am having this. This is A and this is B. For this inside region, this is A union B. A union B dash means outside A union B, outside this much region. So this will be the region, this black lines that you see, this will be the region of A union B dash. So this region is A union B whole dash, okay? Outside A and B. What will be A dash? Let us see. And then B dash and their intersection. Let us check. This is A, this is B. A dash will mean outside A. Outside A means I don't go inside A, I remain outside A. See, I can go inside B, there is no harm, but I should remain outside A. A dash means outside A, but I can remain inside B. This region can come. See, the A circle has been left out blank. This is A dash region. What will be B dash region? Outside B, these red lines. Outside B dash, that means I can go inside A, but I should remain outside B. So like this I do. So B dash means outside A. Okay. Intersection means what? Common region. Where can you see, in which region can you see red and blue lines both? In this much region. Outside A and B. And this is also same. So this was the region A dash intersection B dash, and this was the region A and B whole dash. We can see they are same regions. So by Venn diagram we can prove A union B whole dash will be A dash intersection B dash. And similarly, children, you try out
A intersection B whole dash will be A dash union B dash. See, dash comes on both, intersection becomes union. Union becomes intersection becomes union, and dash is applied to both, distributed to both, like this you remember. Let us see some more points of complement. Dekho. See, if I want a set like A minus B, where is it in the Venn diagram? Let us check. So this is A and this is B. We already know this is A minus B. We already know, children, this is A minus B. We know that this is B minus A. We all know about it. So this is B minus A. This is A minus B. Different set which we studied in the previous exercise. What will be A intersection B dash? Let us check. This is A. This will be B. I want A. A means this much. This is A. And I want B dash. B dash means outside B. This is B for me. The outside B will be this much. Outside B means I can go inside A. There is no harm. But it should remain outside B. So this is the region of outside B. And now I want intersection means where both the type of lines are present in this much region. Can you see? That means this region and this region, they are same. This is A intersection B dash for me. And I can record they are same regions. So children, please remember, A minus B will be A intersection B dash. That means X minus Y will be X intersection Y dash. M minus N will be M intersection N dash. So what you have to do, instead of minus put intersection, and whichever cell is getting subtracted, put complement on that. It will be one and the same thing. Okay. You know this is A minus B. What will be A minus A intersection B? This is A. This is A intersection B, you know. This much is A intersection B. And this is full B. This is full B. This is full A. And this is A intersection B. From A, I wish to subtract A intersection B. So from A, you get rid of A intersection B. So this much region will remain. From this full A, I remove this much region. A intersection B. This much is remaining. But this is again A minus B also. So please remember, A minus B will be as good as A minus A intersection. From Venn diagram you can see. Now children, don't feel that, sir, we subtract, cut out A and A, just like X and X. Cut out this minus sign, therefore B is A intersection B. Don't say like that, because these are not real numbers, these are sets. So rules of algebra don't apply to sets, please understand. Otherwise you may think, just like x minus y equal to x minus x intersection y, x x cut minus cut, so b is equal to a intersection b. No, that is wrong. Have a deeper meaning. Here we are getting rid of those elements of a which are present in b, and we are subtracting a intersection b from a. So whatever is remaining, we are marking that is our set. Okay, so some properties I told you. So please remember all these things which I am writing on the board. Please pause and copy for your sake. Now children, I want to teach you complementary form of interval which is not given in the textbook, but it will be very useful in case of linear inequalities and trigonometry. And a complementary form of interval. See, supposing I am having an interval from 2 to 4, 2 included and 4 not included. I am having these elements with me. So how can I write it in complementary form? See, this means from entire real numbers, I wish to subtract this and this, and therefore this much will remain. I can say like this. This region means from the entire real number line, I will subtract this region and this region, therefore this much will remain. This is infinity and this is minus infinity. So I will say 2, 4 is equal to R minus this interval. So So children, if I write like this, 4 open infinity and this much region, minus infinity to 2. Now, children, please concentrate. What mistake we can make? In this region, from 4 to infinity, I don't have 4 with me because it is open at 4. So once I don't have 4 over here, that means I am not subtracting 4. So 4 will remain with me. In this region, 4 is not included. So I am not subtracting 4 from R because 4 is not included here. So that means 4 I will have with me. But here I don't have 4. So 4 should not come in the answer. Therefore I should subtract 4. So I should close it. If I include 2 over here, so 2 is present in this set. I am removing 2 from R. That means I will not be left with 2. But I am having 2 over here. So I should have 2. I should not subtract 2 from here. Therefore I should not include 2 over here. So open. Please pay attention to this point. How it is happening. Look at more. Please look at more. One more example I am giving. Supposing this is 3 and this is 7. This is open, this is closed. I am having these elements. This is infinity minus infinity. So this can be written as 3, 7 is equal to R minus this region and this region. This means 7 to infinity union. This means minus infinity to 3. Now if I make like this, here 7 is included. So R minus 7, 7 will get subtracted. So I will not have 7 with me, but I want 7. So 7 should not be subtracted, so make it open. Here 3 is not included. So 3 will not get subtracted. I will be left out with 3, but I don't want 3. Because 3 is open here. So I should subtract 3. So I close over here. Please think nicely. Supposing I am having like this. Minus 1 to infinity from here to here. So complementary form will be from the entire real numbers I subtract this much. So I will write R minus. This means minus infinity to minus 1. Supposing I write like this. So minus 1 is not included over here. So minus 1 will not get subtracted. So I will be left out with minus 1. But I don't want minus 1. It is open here. So I should subtract minus 1. So I should close. Please see more. 3. This much region I have got. So for this much region I will think from entire region R I am subtracting this. So this will remain with me. So I can write minus infinity to 3 as R minus this much region means 3 to infinity. Now again see, if I close at 3, that means 3 is there in this interval. So R minus 3, so 3 will get subtracted because it is included here. So I will not have 3 with me, but I want 3 over here. So I should not subtract 3, so I will open it. If the case is like this, my region is this much and this much. So minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. Full R, I subtract this much. So R minus minus 1, 1. If I write like this, then minus 1, 1 are not included. So they will not get subtracted. So I will have minus 1, 1 with me. But here I don't have minus 1, 1. That means I should subtract minus 1 and 1. So that they are not left with me. Because here it is open. Open means the number is not included. So what should come over here? Closed. And finally, if I am having minus 1 closed and 1 closed, from entire real number and I will subtract this. So it will be minus 1 minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity will be equal to R minus this much region. Now we write R minus minus 1 1. Hope now you understand why I'm opening it. Because if I close, then minus 1 1 will be included. They will get subtracted. I will not be left with minus 1 1, but I want minus 1 1. It is closed over here. So I should not subtract minus 1 1. Therefore, at minus 1 1, I'm keeping open. Now, if you see all the cases, wherever there was closed, there it's becoming open. And open means closed. 7th pay closed, here open, 3 open, 3 closed. Minus 1 open, minus 1 closed. 3 closed, 3 open. Minus 1 open, minus 1 closed. 1 open, 1 closed. Minus 1 closed, minus 1 open. 1 closed, 1 open. So when we write complementary form, you have to invert. If it is closed in our given answer, then you have to open in the complementary form like this, you think. Please copy, very important, please copy. See, now we will take up some sums from the textbook. Yes. See, A, U is given to me as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. A is given to me as 1, 2, 3, 4. B is given to me as 2, 4, 6, 8. And C is given to me as 3, 4, 5, 6. We have to write A dash. Pivot elements of A from here, it will become 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. B dash will be pivot elements of B from here, it will become C dash will be pivot 3, 4, 5, 6 like this. We also want A union C whole dash. So first we write A union C. A union C means we write all the elements of A and C. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. A union C dash means I will leave out these elements from U. So this becomes 7, 8, 9. Okay, children, understanding? I want A union B whole dash. So first I get A union B. A union B means take all the elements of A and B. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8. And if I want A union B whole dash, leave out these elements from U. So 1, 2, 3, 4 gone. 5 will come, 7 will come, 9 will come. Then you want A dash dash. So first we write A dash, leave out elements of A. It will be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then we want again dash of it. So leave out these elements from U. So I will be left out with 1, 2, 3, 4. Thus we conclude A double dash should be A itself, important property. Understanding, children? Then. So I think you can do these things very easily. I will do this question for you. Please pause and copy, children. See, the universal set is given to me as all the natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, dot, dot, dot. Then A is a set X such that X is an even natural number. So what will A contain? 2, 4, 6, 8 like these numbers. So A will be in list form 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, dot, dot, dot. So I can easily make out what will be A dash. Leave out these numbers from you. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So all odd numbers. That will be A dash. X is a positive multiple of 3. Positive multiple of 3. X. So what will be B dash, children? B, first I write 3, 6, 12, 15, 18 lines. So what will be B dash? 1, 2, 4, 5, 7, 8, 10, 11, and like this. Always three dots only, children. Please remember, I have told you. Okay. So then, there is a set like C is equal to X such that X is an odd natural number. So what will be elements of C? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13 and so on. That will be C. So what will be C dash, children? Leave out these elements from you. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 or even multiples. Then this is given to me, supposing D, X such that X plus 5 is equal to 8. So what will be X? 3. So D set is got only element 3. So what will be D dash? Leave out this element. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Like this. So I think this one, see. X such that 2X plus 1 more than 10. So, 2x plus 1 more than 10, 2x more than 9, x more than 4.5. So, x will be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, like this. So, what will be E dash, children? Leaving out these numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4. This will be E dash. Okay, then. Please pause and copy. I am trying to do all the typical sums. Easier ones I am leaving out. Please practice out. Let us not waste time in the video. See, children. U is given to me 1 to 9. This is U. A is 2, 4, 6, 8. B is 2, 3, 5, 7. Like this, we already. We have to verify De Morgan's law. They are A union B dash is equal to A dash intersection B dash. And A intersection B dash will be A dash union B dash. We have to verify that. Children, what will be A union B? All elements of A and B. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A union B. So what will be A union B dash? Leave out these elements from U. So 1 and 9. Now RHS A dash. Leave out these elements from U. 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. I am leaving out 2, 4, 6 from here to get A dash. What about B dash? 2, 3, 5, 7 leave out. I am having 1, 4, 6, 8 and 9. I want A dash intersection B dash. RHS. Take common elements. 1 will come. 3 is not there. 5 is not there. 9. So this and this both are equal. Then we want A intersection B. Common elements of A and B. 2, 4 is not there, 6, only 2. So what will be A intersection B dash? And what about A dash and B dash? Children, we have already found out A dash, B dash. Let us unite them. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that will be 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. See, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we can see both are equal. So both the De Morgan's laws also proved. Then, sixth one. See children, let U be the set of all the triangles in the plane. They can be right angle triangles, equilateral triangles, scalene triangles and what not. If A is the set of all triangles with at least one angle different from 60, one angle at least should not be 60. So that means A has got triangles like this. One angle should not be 60 at least. At least means 1, 2, 3. So I take one angle different from 60. Supposing this becomes 70, this becomes 80 and this becomes 30. So here all the three angles are different from 60. We can get that. At least one angle should not be 60. Different from 60 means at least one angle should not be 60. That means 2 can be not 60, 3 may be not 60, but 3 are not 60. Then 2 may not be 60. So 1 may be 60. 2 may not be 60, so 30 or say 40 and 80. At least one angle different from 60. This is okay because there is at least one angle not 60. This is also okay. At least one angle is not 60. So here no angle 60, here one angle 60. Let us try to make a triangle where two angles are 60. No, we can't have because all three will be 60. So here no angle was 60. Here two angles are not 60. And now here we were trying to make one angle not 60. So one angle not 60 we are not getting. So that means this triangle cannot come in A, because we can have a triangle having one angle 60 means two angles not 60 and three angles not 60. But we cannot have a triangle where only one angle is not 60 but remaining two are 60. That cannot happen. So set A contains triangles which are having at least one angle different from 60. At least one angle means three angles can be different from 60. Two angles can be different from 60. One angle different from 60 means I take this 70 or something like this, but these two 60. No, that is not possible. So this type of triangle cannot come. I can have this triangle and this triangle. So this will be A. So naturally, you can see what will be A dash. Which type of triangle was not coming in A? All three angles 60. So A dash will be the set of equilateral triangles 60, 60 and 60. So A dash will be the set of equilateral triangles in the plane. Like this you have to think. So that was all children. Then last exercise is also there, last question. Then we can quickly do our properties. A union A dash, that I told you it will be full U, that you can see from Venn diagram. Properties also you know. A intersection A dash is null set. Phi dash intersection A. Phi dash means U intersection A. In intersection we get smaller set. Naturally U is the bigger set. So A will come. U dash intersection A means phi intersection A. Phi. In intersection we get smaller set. Thank you children. God bless you. And in the next video we will take up the next exercise. Thank you and take care of yourself.